In today's tutorial, I'm going to show you how to create cinema-like animation effect in PowerPoint. As you can see here, I have created this video camera completely in PowerPoint. I have added some the tripod here, and then I have added some reel at the top. So how this works is when I click, the reel will start at spinning or rotating, and then the images or the videos or the text comes out from the camera. So let me just show you. When I click, you can see here it started spinning, and then you can see the light comes out from the camera. Now, depending on your requirement, you can add a text or a video or image. So whatever you can think of, you can just add it here. So let me just click now. So you can see here the first image comes something like this, and when I click, it comes the second one, then the third one, and like this you can add the text also. As I said, you can add some a live video also here, or recorded video also you can add it here. And if you have not subscribed to my channel PowerPoint University, please subscribe it now and make sure to enable the bell notification icon. You can join my Telegram group with the help of this link. And if you like to contribute to my channel, you can do it through PayPal or Patreon. The link is provided in the video description section. I have used Office 2019 to do this. If you are using the older version like 2007 or 2010, some features may not be available. So I highly recommend you to use the latest version of PowerPoint. So let's start the tutorial. Add a new slide, go to View, enable the Guides, then go to Insert, Shapes. From the basic shapes, I'm going to draw a oval shape. Just click it here. The size you can see is 1 inch. I'm going to make it to 1.9, and later on we can increase or decrease also. Shape outline, make it no outline, align center, align middle. Then I'm going to add 6 or 5 small oval shape, the circles again. So I'm just going to press Ctrl D to duplicate. And I'm just going to change the color to any other color of your choice, whichever color you feel, and then hold the shift key, reduce the size, all right, something like this, and then you put it here one by one. So just hold the shift key like this, all right, and then press Ctrl D to duplicate like this. You can just align it. So I've already done that one. Let me just paste that one here like this. You can see here the same thing what I did. I just made it some arrange like this. So you can make it more simple. I'm going to just delete this one. Let me just select this and put it here. Okay, so you can see here all different oval shapes I have created, and then I have just arranged it like this. So once this is done, what you need to do, you need to just select all, or you can press Ctrl A to select all, go to the Format, Merge Shape, I can subtract it. You can see here I have subtracted it like this, right? And then depending on your requirement, you can reduce the size. You can see here I'm just going to hold the shift key, reduce the size, and I'm going to add one more. Press Ctrl D, and for this also I'm going to somewhat reduce the size, a little smaller than the first one, and make sure that it is properly aligned. Or I can just put this aside and I want to use it for the later purpose. Now I'm going to design the video camera. To design the video camera, you need to go to Insert, Shapes. From the rectangles, I'm going to select the rectangles, rounded corners, draw it. Maybe I can just put it here, something like this. And again, do not bother about the size, that can be adjusted later also. So, and then I can just make it somewhat, you can see a less curved, all right. Shape outline, no outline, and shape fill, you can use any blue gray color combination. You can see here I can use this light color combination, and then I'm going to add one rectangle, draw one rectangle here, all right, something like this. In the center, if you want, you can make it. Shape outline, no outline, shape fill, I'm going to give the same color. Then go to Insert, Shapes, I'm going to select this trapezoid, draw the trapezoid, shape outline, no outline, shape fill, somewhat darker color I'm giving, and rotate, I can just rotate left 90 degrees, and I can just make it somewhat You can see here, I'm just going to place it here and make sure that it is properly aligned. If you want, you can just increase the size also, and then you can see the small point here, just drag this inside. Alright, so whichever way you want, you can just adjust it depending on your requirement. So this is done, and then I'm going to select both these shapes, press Ctrl D to duplicate. Alright, Ctrl G to group it. I'm going to reduce the size. You can see here, I'm just reducing the size. Rotate, I'm going to make it flip horizontal, and then I'm adding the other side of the here. Okay, so once this is done, I can add few more shapes here. I can add one rectangle, draw one rectangle here. All right, shape outline, no outline, shape fill, you can use any dark color or any light color also you can use it. And then I'm going to add four small rectangles here, or the squares. So this one should be more lighter color, you can see here, and hold the Ctrl Alt key together, and then again hold the Ctrl Alt key together. Like this, I have added one shape. I'm going to duplicate this one only, and then making it somewhat bigger here. Just a random shape, you know, just to make and feel that, okay, looks like somewhat a camera. Otherwise, if you don't want, you can remove also, not a problem with that one. So like this shape, I'm going to add it here, and then I'm going to add four small round buttons. So you can see here, select the oval shape. All right, you can see here, I have made it 0.05, and this also 0.05. and shape fill, make it white, or I can make it 0.1, this also 0.1, otherwise 0.5 is very small. Shape outline, no outline, and hold the Ctrl Alt key, add one more like this. So 3 or 4 you can add it. Press Ctrl D one more time, and maybe this is 0.15 0.15, and I'm going to put it here. So you can see here, this looks like a kind of a camera. And if you want to change, if you want to add more shapes or more effects, you can use it. So now I can add one, you know, at the bottom one handle, go to insert shapes. From the lines, I'm going to select this curve, just click here, one click here, a small bend I need like this, and double click. Okay, shape outline, I can increase the width. You can see here, I can increase the width like this. Shape outline, give the same color. Insert shapes, I'm going to select this rounded corner rectangle, make it fully curved. Shape outline, no outline. Shape fill, make it somewhat dark color. Reduce the size, and then I'm just going to put it here like this. All right, so something like this. Okay, so this is, and then the last thing what you need to do is you need to put this here at the top, and then we have to add some trapezoid at the bottom. So let's do that part first. So to add the trapezoid, I'm going to select all of these, and I'm going to make it somewhat up. Okay, maybe here I can move it, and then I'm going to add a few more rectangles. Draw one rectangle, maybe this much size, make sure it is in the center. Shape outline, no outline. Shape fill, you can use some dark color, and send this to back. All right, and then I'm going to add one more by pressing Ctrl D, reduce the size. And this is on base, I'm going to make it like this, you can see here. And then I'm going to add again rectangle, or I can just select this, press Ctrl D to duplicate, increase the height, reduce the width, you can see, and then rotate it, the first one. So depending on your requirement, you can adjust the height. Press Ctrl D to duplicate, make it straight, and put it here. And then I'm going to select this and rotate the other side, and I'm just going to put it here like this. All right. And then one more duplicate, reduce the height, make it straight, make it somewhat small, and this is where I'm going to put it like this here. Just align it properly, and that's it. So you can see here, this is done. All right, select these three also. This one, I just need to align it properly, both this one, just somewhat. All right, and then I can select this. I have to give some different light colors, so that looks good. Okay, and bring to front. So like this, you can see here. So the trapezoid is also done. And now I need to add the reels here. So before that one, let me just bring this down here. All right, and I'm going to put it here, bring to front. Let me just move a little bit. Here, if I want, I can just reduce the size also. I can reduce the size further. Okay, so it should be some gap. Now I want to give this white color, but if I give the white color, background also will not be visible. So in that case, I have to change the background color. So I can use any dark color, and then select both of this. Make sure the transparency should not be there. Format, shape fill, make it white. And then I'm going to add one kind of a reel. Go to insert, shapes, select the oval shape, draw the oval shape by holding the shift key, shape outline, no outline, shape fill, make any dark color here, and select like this, put it here and send this to back. Okay, it looks like a reel here. Okay, and press Ctrl D to duplicate, reduce the size and put it in the center for the smaller ring, and this also send this to back. All right, then if you want, you can insert some lines here. Either you can, if you want, you can use this curve one, or you want a freeform shape also. I can take the freeform shape from here till here, and then you can just see that like this. Shape outline, make it dark. Shape fill, no fill. Increase the weight and send this to back. So it looks like a reel here. Okay, so this is also done, and make sure that this is properly aligned, something like this. Okay, so once this is done, what you can do is you can add some animation effect here. How to do the animation effect? Close this one, go to the animations, enable the animation pane. I'm going to select only this white. You can see here only this. So select both this one, add animation, click on spin. So you can see it started spinning. And then I'm going to select both effect options, timings, maybe slower or medium. But this one, repeat, you have to select until end of the slide and click OK. So it will keep on spinning. So when I click, you can see here it is spinning like this. And sometimes if I zoom in, it looks, you can see here, this is looking, you know, outside. So this one I have to just select, and I have to make sure that it should be like this. It should not be visible from there. Okay, okay, right. So this is good. Now our camera is ready. Now it's time to add images or text or whatever you feel better, right? And if you want to align or arrange the camera in such a way that it gives more space for us to show, so you need to select all and then move it towards more towards the left side. Now let me just add some rectangle, one rectangle covering the slide, maybe like this. Shape outline, no outline, shape fill, make it white. And then as if I want to add one shape where the image or the movie is coming out from the camera. So for that, go to insert, shapes, and I'm going to select the same, the trapezoid. Draw the trapezoid, shape outline, no outline, shape fill white, rotate it. I'm going to rotate left 90 degrees, and here I'm going to put it something like this. You can see here, and then small this point, drag this inside. Okay, if it is not aligning properly, what you can do also, you can right mouse click, edit points, also you can just adjust it according to your requirement. So once this is done, what you can do is select this shape and this shape, merge shape, make it union, so it becomes one shape here like this. You can see here, let me just go to view, remove the guides, I don't want guides now. So now for this animation, I'm going to add the wipe animation and select this one, click from left, and should happen with previous but a delay of maybe 0.5 seconds. So how it works, when I click, it started rotating and then this comes here. All right, now depending on your requirement, what image you want to show here, any text or some video also, you can just add it here. So how to do that one is, I'm going to select this one, press Ctrl D to duplicate, so I can have duplicated this one. Let me just close this one, right mouse click, go to format shape, and I'm going to select some pictures here because I've added the picture already. Sometimes what happens here is the picture will be upside down, so you have to click, untick this one, rotate with shape. Okay, so you can see here, and then adjust this one, and I'm going to put it like this. So this is my first image. All right, and if I want to add more images, what I need to do is I have to just duplicate this one, press Ctrl D to duplicate. Okay, and then I can go to insert, I can go and select from file, or I can insert some online pictures also. I'm going to choose some online pictures. You can see here, for this you need to have the active connection, or if you have some good images on your local PC, you can add those images here. So you can see here, it's taking some more time, so maybe I'm going to choose some cars. All right, and some images I'm going to choose which looks better, maybe this one, and insert. You can see here, this image has been added here, and I'm going to place it like this. Okay, just make sure that it is properly aligned. Now if I go to the animation, enable the animation pane, so this one and this one should happen on click, so I will make it on click. This also I'm going to make it on click. So let me just play now. When I click, okay, you can see here the reel started rotating or spinning, and then the image, the light comes from the camera, and when I click, the first image comes, when I click, the second image comes. So depending on your requirement, you can add as many images as you want. If you want to add some text, if you want to add some video, to add the video is very simple. You need to go and click on the video part, and if you want some online videos also, you can add it, or from the local PC also you can add the video here.